Hi guys, welcome back to another episode of the Linux channel. In this episode, I'm going to discuss and going to show you how you can take CPU and hard disk measurements in a typical Linux system. And in this case, I'm going to show you my Ubuntu desktop. You can do the same with any typical Linux flavor, whether it can be Red Hat or Fedora or anything with the the CLI tools which I'm going to use. Usually in the case of Linux world, people do not use a typical Linux system for gaming or something like that. And but at the same time, you may be using your system for some sort of mission critical applications. And at the same time, in case you are using your laptop or you want to access any new processor or a new laptop or any piece of hardware or an embedded board, sometimes it is quite crucial to do these tests before you put extensive load on these systems as such. And you can actually do these tests with the load and without load and stuff like that. And in my case, I use it mainly during kernel compilation on any new hardware, and I'll kind of put the maximum load on the system, and I kind of test the room's ambient temperature before measuring these tests. And then once I know the room's ambient temperature, I'll measure these parameters and compare how far it exceeds and with respect to the load on the system. And sometimes it again depends, whenever you do any sort of water cooling on your processor, you can just check if the installation is correct. And this can be even a server or something like that, wherein in a data center or anywhere, if you install, you can remotely monitor and you can see the overall health of your system as well. So let me just take you guys to my desktop, guys, and show you how it can be done in a typical Linux based system. So guys, here is my desktop, guys. I have pre-installed these tools. This is my personal to-do document which I stored in Google Drive. Usually I have many such Linux tutorials which I have personally edited them. Sometimes I get them from online and then I edit it with my information and my output as such. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this installation steps in this YouTube description, excluding this test results, so that you can just copy paste and you can install it in your system also. So coming back to my system, this is my Ubuntu system, guys. This is a Intel i7 5820K processor, and this is having 6 core processor, and with hyper threading it shows totally 12 cores. So you can just type the command as sensors. So with this command, as you can see, it shows the output of each physical core temperature of the processor. You can just see over here. And sometimes whenever you do system loading or you apply more load on the CPU or something like that, you can just see the temperature changes and stuff like that. In my case, since this is a water cooled system, even with the full load on all the cores during the kernel compilation or something, around 80% of load on around more than 10 cores or something like that, I typically hit around 50 degrees Celsius as such. But in a case if it is air cooled cooling block, I think it may touch around 75 to 80 degrees Celsius. So you can use this command to check your processor temperature. And for measuring hard disk temperature, you have another tool called as hddtemp, as you can see here. So with this you can measure the hard disk's temperature. Let me just show you. You need to access this command with a sudo permission. So you can just do sudo hddtemp /dev/stl. So yeah, as you can see here, this is my hard disk, which it is currently showing its temperature is around 25 degrees Celsius. This is my one of the SSD drive, so it is just showing it is around this temperature. Let me just check whether I can just measure the temperature of my other hard disk. So this is my other hard disk, guys. So I can just do a df command. Yeah, the other hard disk, this is actually a sort of
laptop hard disk which I installed in my desktop system, which is around close to 1 TB. So it is in HDB. So let me just measure the temperature of this hard disk also. Yeah, as you can see here, it is relatively hotter than my SSD drive. So this is how you can measure the temperature of your hard disk. So long ago I used to work in Akamai, and I used to work in, you know, service performance. So usually we used to measure the health of the system sitting at one place of all the caching devices across the world. So you know, we need to rely on such tools so that you can pull this information, and if you are smart enough, you can aggregate in a database, and then you know, you can just plot a graph, and you can just measure your remote data center devices or any sort of servers across the world. So here is the guide, guys. What I'm going to do is I'm going to copy paste this installation steps. You need to install this application lm-sensors. So you need this lm sensors, and then you need to also install this hddtemp, and then apart from that, you need to follow these steps. So that's all, guys, for this episode. I hope you guys liked watching this video. Please do subscribe to this channel, guys, and in case if you like this video, please hit the like button. Thank you. Have a nice day.